Hi everyone, this is Natalie, and I wanted to share some tips on how to garden or grow food from kitchen scraps. So these would be parts of foods that maybe you're getting at the grocery store or at the farmer's market. You're putting it in a recipe, and then you have these leftover bits and pieces that you normally throw out, or maybe you compost. But I'm gonna show you a lot of these foods can actually be regrown into new plants. So one of the foods that you can regrow from kitchen scraps is celery. So since I've been using a lot of celery for cooking or snacks or experiments, I've been finding myself with a lot of celery scraps. So the celery scrap is the part on the end that you're not eating, you're cutting off anyway, and normally I would just throw it out or compost it. But I have recently learned how to regrow this plant. It's really easy. It only takes a few days to see the growth, which is really exciting.
So what you would normally do if you're cooking with celery or making a snack with celery is you would cut off a few inches from the bottom. So it's the same if you're trying to regrow the celery. So what you do is you cut a few inches from the bottom, and I'm just using, you really don't need that sharp of a knife. Which means your kids can help you out with this if you want to make it a fun science activity. So you will cut through the celery. You'll use this for a snack. I'll link some recipes below. Set that aside. And now you're left with the bottom of your celery plant.
So once you have the bottom of your celery cut off,
you'll just grab a bowl or a jar, or I put some of the celery in these old yogurt containers. That works really well, or any, you know, old to-go containers, and just put a little bit of water in the bottom. You want the water really to only be covering less than an inch of the celery plant. So all you have to do is, like I said, drop some water in your jar or bowl, drop your celery in, and put it in a windowsill, or if you have a back porch, you can put it outside, anywhere where it will get sunlight. And you'll start to see growth in a couple of days. I was actually really surprised by how quickly new growth occurred, and I'll show you some pictures here.
So once you have your celery in the container, be sure to change the water every couple days. So after some time in the water, you will see your celery start to have some really strong growth. This is now about 2 weeks, and this is a little bit less than 2 weeks, and same with this one over here. I planted these each 2 days apart, and you'll see this one I just planted the other day, so that one is starting to grow, but that's still new growth, so I'm gonna wait to replant that. But once the celery has some strong growth of leaves, you're going to want to replant it into some potting soil. So ideally, you will plant it in a container that is 8 inches deep with plenty of space for the roots to grow. So I'll be using this pot that I just had lying around from an older plant, but you don't need to be using anything fancy. For example, I'm growing some lettuce in an old lettuce container. I cut some holes in the bottom, so that's an example. Or maybe a milk jug, for example. So you can grow in a lot of different things. All right, so once you have your pot ready with some potting soil and you have your plant, your celery plant with strong leaf growth, and it's looking good, really green leaves, we'll go ahead and make a hole in your pot, just a space for your celery to go, right, a couple inches deep. And we're gonna take it out of the water. We're gonna nestle the celery just right into the soil. And we will cover up to the leaves. All right, so I have my celery planted in the soil. As you can see, the portion of the original celery plant that we cut off is underneath the soil, but you should see the leaves continue to grow, and hopefully soon the stalks will also continue to grow, and you'll have yourself a new celery plant. Remember that your plant needs water, it needs some sun, so put it in a sunny space. For example, I have, you can see different containers of plants growing in my back patio, or you can put it in your windowsill. So I hope you were able to see just how easy it is to grow a celery plant from leftover scraps and that you consider trying it the next time you are using celery in a recipe.